It's no secret that the universe is an extremely vast place. All matter in the universe, no matter how big, small, young or old, is made up of atoms. Each of these building blocks consists of a positively charged nucleus made up of protons and neutrons and negatively charged orbiting electrons. The number of protons, neutrons and electrons an atom has determines which element it belongs to on the periodic table and influences how it reacts with other atoms around it. Everything you see around is just a configuration of different atoms interacting with one another in unique ways. So, if everything in the universe is made up of atoms, do we know how many atoms are in the universe? To start out of small, there are around 7 octillion or 7 followed by 27 zeros atoms in an average human body, according to the Kurzgesagt. Given this vast sum of atoms in one person alone, you might think it would be impossible to determine how many atoms are in the entire universe. And you would be right, because we have no idea how large the entire universe really is. We can't find out how many atoms are within it. However, it is possible to work out roughly how many atoms are in the observable universe, the part of the universe that we can see and study, using some cosmological assumption and a bit of math. The observable universe. The universe was created during the Big Bang 13.8 billion years ago, as it exploded into existence from a single point of infinite mass and temperature. The universe began expanding outward and has not stopped since. Because the universe is 13.8 billion years old, and the observable universe stretches as far away from us as light can travel in the time since the universe was born, you might assume that the observable universe stretches only 13.8 billion light years in every direction. But because the universe is constantly expanding, this isn't the case. When we observe a distant galaxy or a star, what we are really seeing is where it was when it first emitted the light. But by the time the light reaches us, the galaxy or a star is much farther away than it was when we saw it. Using cosmic microwave background radiation, we can work out how fast the universe is expanding. And because that expanding rate is constant, which is currently scientists' best guess, that means that the observable universe actually stretches 46 billion light years in all the directions. This means the current size of the observable universe is 93 billion light years. But knowing how big the observable universe is doesn't tell us everything we know about how many atoms are in it. We also need to know how much matter or stuff is in it. Cosmic assumptions. Matter is not the only thing in the universe. However, in fact, it makes up only about 5% of the universe, according to NASA. The rest consists of dark energy and dark matter. But because they are not made up of atoms, we don't need to worry about them for this mystery. According to Einstein's famous E equal to mc square equation, energy and mass or matter are interchangeable. So it is possible for matter to be created from or transformed into energy. But on the cosmic scale of the universe, we can assume that the amount of matter created and uncreated cancel out each other. This means matter is finite, so there are the same number of atoms in the observable universe as there always have been. This is important because our picture of the observable universe is not a single snapshot in time. According to our observation of the known universe, the physical laws that govern it are the same everywhere. Combined with the assumption that the expansion of the universe is constant, this means that on a large scale, matter is uniformly distributed throughout the cosmos, a concept known as the cosmological principle. In other words, there are no regions of the universe that have more matter than others. This idea allows scientists to accurately estimate the number of stars and galaxies in the observable universe, which is useful because most atoms are found within stars. Knowing the observable universe size and that matter is equally and finitely distributed across it makes it a lot easier to calculate the number of atoms. However, there are a few more assumptions we have to make before we break out the calculator. First, we must assume that all atoms are contained within stars, even though they are not, and most stars are condensed into galaxies, most galaxies into clusters, most clusters into superclusters, and finally into the largest scale structures like the Great Wall of Galaxies. Unfortunately, we have much less accurate idea of how many planets, moons, and space rocks there are in the observable universe compared with stars, which means it is harder to add them into the equation. But because the vast majority of atoms in the universe are contained within stars, we can get a good approximation of the number of atoms in the universe by figuring out how many atoms there are in the stars and ignoring everything else. Second, we must assume that all atoms in the universe are hydrogen atoms, even though they are not. Hydrogen atoms account for around 90% of the total atoms in the universe, according to Los Alamos National Laboratory, and an even higher percentage of the atoms in the stars which we are focusing on. Now, it's finally time to do the math. To work out the number of atoms in the observable universe, we need to know its mass, which means we have to find out how many stars there are. Well, a German supercomputer ran a simulation and estimated that around 200 billion to 2 trillion galaxies contained in the observable universe, and each galaxy contains between 10 to the power 11 to 10 to the power 12 stars, according to European Space Agency. This gives us somewhere between 10 to the power 22 and 10 to the power 24 stars. For the purposes of this calculation, we can say that there are around 10 to the power 23 or 160 trillion stars in the observable universe. Of course, this is just a best guess. Galaxies can range in size and number of stars, but because we can't count them individually, this will have to do for now. According to Science ABC, on average, a star weighs around 10 to the power 32 kilograms, which means that the mass of the universe is around 10 septendecillion kilograms, or 1 followed by 55 zeros. Now that we know the mass or amount of matter, we need to see how many atoms fit into it. On average, each gram of matter has around 10 to the power 24 or 1 septillion protons, according to Fermilab, a national laboratory for particle physics in Illinois. That means it is the same as the number of hydrogen atoms, because each hydrogen atom has only one proton. This gives us 10 to the power 82 atoms in the observable universe. In layman terms, that works out between 10 quadrillion bezentillion and 100,000 quadrillion bezentillion atoms. Or in simple word, you can say that 1 followed by 82 zeros. Once again, this number is just a rough estimate. When used to estimate the total mass of the universe, it often falls short of what other estimates predict. And in the end, what we see is just a small fraction of the whole.